move on to Paul's Ponderings.
I want to hear Paul's Ponderings. Tell me everything that's gone through your head this week,
man. All right, this week, I don't know. I can't remember what. Oh, I think what inspired me for this one. I don't know what inspired me for this one, but I'm going to look at some Melbourne. This week, we're going to look at Melbourne Storm graffiti slash street art slash murals, whatever sort of you want to call it, that big public walls with Melbourne Storm stuff on it. So I've got a bit of a collection here that I found. So let me just get this up. A few of the locations quite easily we can sort of pick where they are. But the other ones, hang on, sorry, where'd it go? Sorry, I'm a bit of a, let me just get this up again. But a few of them are actually, I'm not sure where they're actually located, but maybe here we go. So can you see that? Are we on sharing?
See you perfect now. Well, we know where that. Well, there we go.
Well, sorry. This is our first. I don't know where this one is, but this one's really cool.
I really like that 2017 Premiers with the Melbourne CBD skyline. It's very nicely done. There's an artist name down the bottom right, I think. Or maybe that's just a.
Is it? Yeah. Sorry, I can't. I did look up one of the artist names. I didn't even plug, but I forgot. So sorry.
That looks like it's something that's been commissioned by a local council or by the club or something like that. It's a very nicely professionally done one.
Yep, I really like that one. This one's Billy Slater.
How could you not? That's clearly Richmond train station, the bridge coming across one street there.
Now, this artist, I'm really, I should have wrote his name down, but he's done a whole bunch of this rugby league sort of, not just rugby league, he's got his own website. Maybe I'll endeavour to find him and I'll put his name in the description of the video. He's done a bunch of ones for other teams too in Sydney. So, but
really cool.
Yeah, it's but look how like lifelike. It looks like a photo. It's amazing.
It really does. That is exceptional work. Portrait work there.
Yeah. Now this one. This is a recent one. This is as you can see with the Storm man with the mask. This is Molly Mount Meldrum's wall. Have you ever passed Molly Mount Meldrum?
I have a few times. I have in my many, many trips into the MCG or Amy Park. There is a way you can cut through if you want to avoid some of the through traffic. I think I can't remember the name of the street. It's not Johnston Street, but it's one of those streets that runs up towards East Richmond Station. Beg your pardon, West Richmond Station.
Yeah, so Molly loves changing up his artwork on his wall. I've driven past it once accidentally, and I was going to say, well, it's a Melbourne Storm thing on someone's wall. So that's obviously recently.
And he's got St Kilda on the other half of that, which is his other sporting love. But Molly, of course, a huge Melbourne Storm fan.
We're actually, when I say we, it's more my fiance. She's making a fence for us now. And, she's like, what colour? Should I get it this stain and that stain? And they're like, well, can we paint the fence like navy, purple, white and yellow? And she's like, I don't think so. I was like, I want a fence that shows your team.
Now that is beautiful.
This is Molly Meldrum's wall again, obviously at a different time. He's got Ryan Hoffman, Cooper Cronk still in there, obviously.
Cronk's just had a little bit of a line or a question mark put next to it, maybe an asterisk.
Oh, well, there you go. 2012 grand final, if you can see under that Getty Images watermark. This one was down Hosier Lane. So famous Hosier Lane, 356. This is celebrating Cam Smith breaking the all-time games record. So this was a pretty cool one. Don't know if this one's still there.
Couple of years back, a fantastic achievement by Cameron, and he just keeps building on that record too, trying to make sure that no one ever passes it.
Yep. This one is back in 2017. I don't know where this is now. You have to look hard to see the Storm reference. So you can see it's Melbourne City. So this was after before the 2017. So you got the big tiger. So it's Eat the Crows, because I believe Richmond played Adelaide, and then Fry the Cowboys. And you can see it's a cowboy hat getting electrocuted there. So I threw this one in there because it's not really that obvious.
Now, that's not Hosier Lane, but actually that's close to it, isn't it? I think that's...
I don't know.
It's not ACDC Lane, is it?
Don't know. You probably know. I rarely go into the CBD anymore.
Those windows are very familiar. I couldn't tell you exactly where it is, though.
Yeah.
But that's pretty cool.
The next one's
that's also very cool.
That's the same artist as the Billy Slater one. And I believe this is also at Richmond Station.
That certainly looks like Richmond Train.
Yep. Again, really lifelike. A bit incompleted there. But yeah, I'm pretty sure this one's up there at the moment. So if you live within 5 kilometres of Richmond Station, get out there to take a photo with it.
Go and enjoy it.
Yeah. Now, this one isn't Melbourne Storm, but this was just a funny one I found when I was looking for some stuff.
Chris, don't bother after.
Yeah, it's an interesting way of communicating with someone, considering you've got all these different forms of ways you can communicate and contact people these days. But there you go. That's Paul's Ponderings. Melbourne Storm graffiti street art murals from...
Outstanding.
Yeah.
That's